There was a hawkish tone from the U.S. Federal Reserve as they raised rates to the highest level in 15 years, and they signaled that more hikes are ahead. Joining us now for his reaction, Chris Whelan, Senior Canada Rates Strategist at TD Securities. Chris, great to have you with us. Let's talk about what we got out of the Fed. It seems like they're getting ready to say goodbye to 2022. You got the central bank sort of singing that song they've been singing for a while.
Yeah, I think we're all tired of the broken record now that we have going on this year, a tight labor market, persistent inflation. We need to bring rates higher. I think yesterday's bond market reaction and I think the stock market reaction we're seeing is telling us that these rate hikes are going to be tough for the economy to absorb. I think we definitely have a highly indebted world, and I think we're quite sensitive to interest rates. So I think the markets are bracing for what's probably not going to be a wonderful 2023 economically. And on our side, we could think that the Federal Reserve could still raise rates another 1% from here on the Fed effective rate. So still more pain ahead, I guess we'll call it. And until this until things can resolve themselves and we can see those inflation numbers come down and the job and the labor market ease a little more.
What's been sort of surprising me about all this is that the message that we got yesterday isn't far off the message that really, if you go back to Jackson Hole, when Jerome Powell seemed to want to say, listen, we're pretty serious about this fight against inflation. Yeah. You got to listen to what we're saying. But in between those events, you get the market sort of saying, they're probably close to being done. And that optimism sort of creeps in. I mean, what's the dynamic here where the market keeps thinking, maybe we don't believe you until we hear from you again, and then we believe you again?
Right. I think the market is actually starting to get a good idea of where terminal rates are going to be. I think they're comfortable with them getting to somewhere in the 4.75 to 5%, or we think a little bit higher than that. But I think the market is starting to get a more narrow band on where they see the terminal rate path ending up. I think that that's providing some clarity for the bond market. And I think that that's actually giving some stability to the bond market further out the curve. So I think you make a good point where we've been going in and out on are they going to pause? Is there going to be a pause? Is there going to be a pivot? And we kind of go back and forth. So now I think that the market is kind of re-gearing up for that pivot and pause, but not here. It's a pause away now. So that there's a bit of a change in tone where we used to think they're going to pause imminently or there was going to be a pivot imminently. Now we're thinking about a pause at least 50 beeps, at least 0.5% higher than where we are currently on the overnight rate. So I think we're in a bit of a different regime. And I think that the market is acting like that, like we have some clarity and kind of consensus on where we end up on the overnight rate. I think we know that we can't go to 10%. I don't think we're going to make it through that. So I think we're starting to be comfortable with this five-ish area on the effective rate in the U.S.
What about this idea? And we got new economic projections as well. And the Fed seems to be assured that even though they're going to continue raising rates to try to tamp down inflation and slow the economy, they're not going to throw the economy over a cliff. That they're just going to find this perfect place where they can, you know, bring the consumer costs and inflation into line without doing too much economic damage, really even too much damage to the labor market. Is that possible?
I think there's definitely an argument to be made that we can do it because the data, the economic, there's components of the economic data that have been holding up well, and so it kind of depends on how the job market evolves. We've seen some job turnover and dynamics turning up in the technology sector. We'll see how that pours over, and we'll see how the kind of 2023 realizes. I think we all know there's a delayed effect on the higher interest rates. So it depends. It really depends how that realizes. And I think no one is really comfortable with what they know. I think on our side, we think that. A soft landing becomes very difficult as you move through the year next year. But at the moment, the data may unfortunately hold up just a bit too long to get them to hike a bit too far to then give us a bit more pain than we would have liked. We'll see how that evolves. But I mean, the soft landing scenario is so difficult, and when we're hiking at the magnitude we are with the debt levels that we have today. So I think that engineering the soft landing is a lower probability than not.
Do you think the banks are operating right now with an extra dose of humility? I mean, if we back up a year, go, you have the central banks, okay, we know the consumer prices are getting out of, you know, where we want them to be, but don't worry, it's all transitory. Once we can work through this disruption, everything's going to be fine. At some point, they had to admit everything's not going to be fine. Is there more humility in their work right now?
I think there's some humility in their work, but then I think we are... I'm surprised that we're not acknowledging downside risks as much as we are. So we've kind of shifted from it's transitory, which got us behind the ball. So we should have been hiking earlier in the year at a stronger rate than we are now. Now we're in catch up. And then now we're sustaining these at least 50 beep hikes each time, which is still a notable pace. And then as we move forward, I'm surprised we don't have humility to the downside risk that this poses, and that we're becoming so confident that we need to keep going, and that's the way forward. So I'm not sure the humility is there. I think we've almost shuffled from it's transitory to this is going to keep going to okay, well, maybe this isn't going to keep going. So I'm not sure the humility is totally there, but I think it definitely. There's some humility there because that transitory call wasn't the best call.
Could that be one of the reasons why the markets don't seem to fully believe in between inflation reports and then between Fed announcements and other central bank announcements what they're being told? I mean, they seem to believe it today in the aftermath of the Fed, but
yes.
Sometimes do market participants step back and say, listen, you got it wrong a year ago. You got it wrong a couple times. Why should we trust you this time?
Right. I think right now the bond market is saying, I think part of the bond market reaction is that it's moving with yields moving lower out the curve, or at least flattening, is that's, you can argue that that's one part, the market not believing them, or you could, and on the flip side, the market believing them and knowing that that's going to cause pain. But I think either way, the market's telling you that long-term interest rates are not where we're going to end up this cycle. This is. I think we've said it. I think we talked about this before. This is more of an adjustment. We overshoot here. We take the wind out of the sail, and we bring this back into check, and then we see what we can do to manage damage when we're back there. But at least we're not fighting an inflation problem. And I think that's that. I think it's kind of a broken record. It's just fight inflation at the expense of all else. And that seems to be the motivation and the overarching framework here.